Elon Musk is really giving Klaus Schwab a hard time at the World Economic Forum, and boy, are they fighting back with all they've got. But hold on tight, because this situation is spiraling out of control, and nobody knows where it's headed or how it'll impact Americans. Just the other day, during a fancy gathering, Vera Jourova, the European Commission's Vice President for Values and Transparency, decided to give Elon Musk a piece of her mind. She boldly declared, "Hey, Mr. Musk, the era of the Wild West is long gone." And she didn't stop there. She said, "We're all for freedom of speech, just like you. We're also responsible for protecting people from illegal stuff online, you know? So here's the deal. We've got rules, and if you don't follow them, be prepared for some serious consequences." That's a clear message indicating they won't let Elon Musk expose them any further. The battle is on. Elon Musk, the CEO of Tesla and Twitter, never holds back when it comes to exposing the truth about corrupt organizations like the World Economic Forum or the WEF. Lately, he's been focused on calling out Klaus Schwab, the head honcho of the WEF, and spotlighting his actions. However, before we begin our video, we would greatly appreciate it if you would subscribe to our YouTube channel and also press the bell icon. Now, let's get started. Now let's talk about Elon Musk and Klaus Schwab. These guys are big players in the business and tech world and have made their mark. However, their viewpoints have also stirred up quite a bit of controversy. Elon Musk in particular is known for his strong opinions on various topics like artificial intelligence, climate change, and the future of work. He's not a fan of organizations like the World Economic Forum, as he believes they prioritize global interests and corporate agendas over the well-being of workers and the environment. And you can bet he's not shy about speaking his mind on these matters. Klaus Schwab advocates for globalization and the role of corporations in shaping the world's future through a fourth industrial revolution. This vision, characterized by rapid technological change and interconnectedness, has sparked a heated debate. Elon Musk, on the other hand, strongly criticizes the World Economic Forum and similar organizations. He sees them as outdated dinosaurs, out of touch with the realities of the modern world and driven by self-interest. Musk believes they fail to keep up with the fast-paced advancements in technology and society, posing a threat to workers and the environment. In response, Schwab and the World Economic Forum emphasize their positive contributions and the platform they provide for global leaders to tackle pressing issues. The clash between Musk and Schwab highlights the ongoing discourse on the future of technology and its impact, leaving the outcome uncertain. It's worth noting that the World Economic Forum, under Schwab's leadership, has played a pivotal role in discussing crucial topics such as the future of work, technology's impact on society, and the importance of sustainable development. The contrasting viewpoints of Elon Musk and Klaus Schwab hold significant implications for the future of the world. Elon Musk's relentless focus on technology and innovation has yielded remarkable advancements in areas like space exploration and electric vehicles. In contrast, Schwab's vision of a fourth industrial revolution actively shapes the future of work and the global economy. Both individuals have prompted widespread contemplation on the societal repercussions of technology and the role corporations play in shaping our world. Some folks think that Klaus Schwab is too closely connected with big corporations and believe that his ideas prioritize globalization and corporate profits, often neglecting the welfare of workers and the environment. Now let's move on to the second point. Criticism of his environmental policy. Some environmentalists have raised concerns about Klaus Schwab's lack of focus on protecting the environment and his emphasis on economic growth at the expense of ecological sustainability. Another area of controversy is Klaus Schwab's views on ethics. Some people find his ideas on technology and its role in society to be contentious. They believe his vision promotes a future dominated by technology lacking in human values and ethical considerations. It's a widely recognized fact that power can corrupt even the most well-intentioned individuals, causing them to overlook their double standards. This phenomenon is currently playing out in the case of Klaus Schwab as the question of his eventual successor looms over the future of the World Economic Forum. The organization's identity and influence have long been closely tied to Schwab, but his hold on it gradually diminishes. This poses a significant challenge for an event that has been so closely associated with a single person for an extended period. The outcome of this situation will profoundly impact the future of the World Economic Forum and its role in shaping the global economy and society. The next individual or group taking charge of the World Economic Forum will face a significant challenge to succeed. One crucial issue that needs attention is the organization's failure to acknowledge and adapt to the evolving dynamics of power and influence in the digital age. With the advent of the internet, the traditional understanding of power holders and stakeholders has been dramatically reshaped. Now, those who wield substantial influence in the digital realm, even if they are often labeled as spreaders of misinformation or conspiracy theories by the elite, cannot be dismissed, silenced, or excluded from an inclusive and diverse platform. Overlooking these groups would mean disregarding valuable perspectives and insights. It could also undermine the credibility of the World Economic Forum as an institution that truly represents and upholds democratic values. While Elon Musk is widely recognized as a prominent engineer in our time, Klaus Schwab is known for a completely different reason. Schwab's notable achievement lies in his entrepreneurial spirit and transformation of the World Economic Forum. He has turned it from a gathering of policy experts into a glitzy assembly that attracts some of the wealthiest individuals worldwide. Schwab has accomplished this by building strong connections with influential figures, particularly the billionaire class often referred to as Davos Man. Schwab has effectively created a sanctuary for the immensely affluent, where they can engage in business activities and other endeavors while projecting an image of involvement in a noble and virtuous event. The fact that individuals attend the World Economic Forum in Davos gives off the impression of empathy and social awareness, even though their underlying motives might be more self-serving. However, it's important to acknowledge that you and I would never receive an invitation to such an event because we lack the influence and power to benefit the top elite who attend. Similarly, Elon Musk isn't invited due to his unfavorable stance towards Klaus Schwab's community. Within the forum, Klaus Schwab orchestrates one-on-one meetings between leaders of major banks, energy corporations, and presidents from various nations. During these encounters, requests are made for favorable tax arrangements and access to profitable oil reserves. Consulting firms and technology companies also aim to secure government agreements by directly engaging with key decision makers. High-level executives possess the ability to travel and hold discussions with multiple national leaders within a few days, all within private soundproof rooms away from the scrutiny of securities, regulators, journalists, and other potential obstacles. A recent report published ahead of Davos reveals that the wealthiest 1% of the world has amassed almost twice as much new wealth as the rest of the population over the past 2 years. However, this year's gathering will witness significant absences and missed opportunities for Klaus Schwab's organization. Notable figures skipping the event include US President Joe Biden, China's Xi Jinping, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, French President Emmanuel Macron, and UK Prime Minister Rishi Sunak. This raises concerns about whether Davos can maintain its reputation as a vital gathering for the affluent and influential. Is this a sign of Klaus Schwab being defeated by critics like Elon Musk, or is it merely a calm before an approaching storm? Only future events will unveil the answer. And that's it for today. We hope you found our video interesting. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and share it with others. Also, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to our channel. Don't forget to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss any of our new uploads. In the end, thanks for watching and see you next time.